But it was his vision that this week for our introit that we have, it's a good thing he's not here, that I know I'm just thinking about myself, right? That the congregation join in our introit. So for our introit this morning, it's when morning gilds the skies. We're just singing verse 1. So feel free to join in. So I'm not singing by myself.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to Christ Church UCC. No matter who you are or where you are in life's journey, you are welcome here. This morning, Larry wanted me to relay that Dorothy is out of the hospital, so she's home. So that is a good thing. Barbara Ross continues to do well. She is back at home, so in case you've been sending her cards elsewhere, you can redirect them to her home. Don't forget Friday, we have our first holiday sing-along. So 7 o'clock here, and admission is very expensive. No, it's not. Just bring either a can or a box of food so that we can donate to the food pantry. And if you don't have one of them, that's okay. You can still come along. Then we'll have some cookies, specially baked by Judy. No. And something to drink. Water, Judy?
Water
and Coke. And Coke. Okay. So there you go. So you'll have those things on Friday, so make sure to join us. Invite your friends, invite your family, whoever you want to drag. If you're driving this way and you want to pick up a stranger, that's fine too. So just don't get into danger. And I want to thank everybody who helped yesterday for our Santa and Mrs. Claus cookies and chocolate. We had all of our Christian Ed kids here since they rehearsed yesterday morning for today's pageant. And we actually had a visitor who found us on Facebook, so that was good. Adorable little two-year-old girl. So if you have Facebook, you can go online and you can see the pictures from yesterday. I won't say who Mr. and Mrs. Santa Claus, Santa and Mrs. Claus are, that in case, ruin the belief of some folks. So if you really want to know who they are, you can always come and ask me or one of the other adults who probably knows who they are, particularly Mrs. Claus. So. Thank you, and thank you for Christianette for putting our Christmas pageant together for today. The kids have a pretty awesome pageant to put on. So, lucky for you, you get to hear them instead of hearing me during a sermon. So, I know you're hurt. It's okay. No. So, if there's no other announcements.
I have the sign-ups for the live nativity. They'll be in the office. I'm putting it in after church today.
So if you want to sign up for the live nativity, seeing the sign-up will be in the office. So please make sure you do that. And any questions you can ask Donna or Irene. Mighty one, the Spirit of the Lord rests upon your chosen one. The Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and fear of the Lord. As we behold your glory in the heavens, breathe your passion for justice into our hearts, that we may defend the poor, deliver the oppressed, and help the weary. In the season of Advent, may your righteousness flourish and may your peace abound, that none shall hurt or destroy any on all your holy mountain. And Jesus is saying, we pray as we enter the silent prayer. Dig deep, we reach out, we rise up. We remember, we vision, we sit with the pain. We stay with the trouble, we wait, expectant. We light candles, we labor, we open to you and to one another and to the sacred mystery that is Emmanuel, God with us, love incarnate, divinity in flesh.
The peace of God with us does not come as love, and order or enforcement and control.
Peace cannot be imposed from on high. Peace cannot be commanded.
The peace of God with us is chaotic, wild, unruly, unpredictable.
The peace of God with us is collected, liberating us from deadly complicity.
Peace is gestating in darkness. It comes unexpectedly. Peace invites our expectation and demands our participation. Prepare the way for peace with justice.
May peace work among, within, and through us this day. O come, O come, Emmanuel.
Please stand in body or spirit for our call to worship. A shoot has come forth from the stump of Jesse.
The Spirit of the Lord rests upon his shoulders.
Wisdom guides his feet.
Righteousness is the belt around his waist.
Faithfulness is the mantle upon his shoulders.
Counsel and might cover his head.
A shoot has come forth from the stump of Jesse.
God's promised salvation is at hand.
You may be seated. Please join me in our prayer of reconciliation. Living God, we long to wake from sleep, for your kingdom has drawn near. Already the axe is lying at the foot of the tree, and we yearn for you to return to you once more. May our spirits bear the fruit of repentance. We desire the blessings to be found when we respond to the prophets of old by dedicating our lives to you in word and deed. Amen. Let us take a moment for silent confession. Hear now our assurance of grace. Hold fast to the promises of God, promises of steadfast love and forgiveness. Abide in the grace of Christ, Rest in the power of the Holy Spirit. Do this and you will know life eternal. I invite you now to stand in body or spirit and share a sign of peace by waving to each other. Please stand in body or spirit for our gospel reading, which today comes from Matthew chapter 3, verses 1 through 12. In those days, John the Baptist appeared in the wilderness of Judea, proclaiming, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven has come near." This is the one of whom the prophet Isaiah spoke when he said, "The voice of one crying out in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight." Now John wore clothing of camel's hair with a leather belt around his waist, and his food was locusts and wild honey. Then Jerusalem and Judea and all the region around the Jordan were going out to him, and they were baptized by him in the river Jordan, confessing their sins. But when he saw many of the Pharisees and Sadducees coming for his baptism, he said to them, "You brood of vipers, who warned you to flee from the coming wrath? Therefore, bear fruit worthy of repentance, and do not presume to say to yourselves, 'We have Abraham as our ancestor.' For I tell you, God is able from these stones to raise up children to Abraham. Even now, the axe is lying at the root of the trees. Therefore, every tree that does not bear good fruit will be cut down and thrown into the fire. I baptize you with water for repentance, but the one who is coming after me is more powerful than I, and I am not worthy to carry his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire, his winnowing fork in his hand, and he will clear his threshing floor and will gather his wheat into the garnery, but the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire." Here ends our gospel reading. Do not place a period where God has placed a comma. for God is still speaking. You may be seated.
Whoa, girl, steady now. That's a girl. Good horse. Well, I'll just turn you out here to graze in the churchyard.
Phew, what a ride. That Daisy Bell is sure frisky. Things look mighty nice here. In here, it's good to be in this place. Dear diary, well, I finally made it to this place. Mighty nice place. I was sure tickled to get this here invitation from the preacher. Look at this thing. It's been through a lot. Why, it was postmarked on August 30th and delivered on December 12th. Preacher said the church was fixing to have a Christmas program here, and that me and Wild Bill Hiccup and Claire the Calamity Kid was all invited. Yahoo, it weren't easy getting here. It had to wrestle a polecat in Woodridge and got jumped by a varmint in Rosemont. But we're here now, or should I say I'm here now. I'll be dadgum if I know where Wild Bill and Claire are. Well, dear diary, I'm signing off for now. I'm going to snuggle up with this here blanket and wait for the fun to begin. I'm also going to watch for Wild Bill and Claire.
Oh, Ed, that was powerful good. You kids are good singers.
Me too.
Oh, give me a nest where the buffalo rest.
Whoa, Wild Bill. That's enough. Your singing is getting better and better, but don't go over practicing now.
Thanks, Clement. I'm still confused, though. What is all this baby stuff? The kids were singing about it, too. How can a baby preach or teach or heal or die on the cross?
Here comes somebody. Maybe you'll answer soon.
Registration was taken, but the previous was Governor Street.
as a little baby so that he'd really know how I feel when I'm tired or sad or when I'm tempted. This here baby, why, he'll know what it feels like to be a man someday. It all makes sense. What a good plan. By golly, when God does it, he does it right.
Please join me in our new creed. We believe in God, who has created and is creating, who has come in the true man Jesus to reconcile and make new, who works in us and others by their Spirit. We trust in them. They call us to be their church, to celebrate their presence, to love and serve others, to seek justice and resist evil, to proclaim Jesus, crucified and risen, our judge and our hope. In life, in death, in life beyond death, God is with us. We are not alone. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
us go up to God's holy mountain, the mountain of love revealed to us in Christ Jesus. Let's go to join in the feast of grace shown to us at this table of holy communion. Come to this abundant feast, this mountain of love, that our hearts and minds may be prepared to receive the coming Christ. The Holy One be with you. Open your hearts to the one who is love.
We open our hearts to you, O God.
We open our hearts to you, Let us give thanks to God with us.
To the one who took on flesh, we give thanks and praise.
Creator of all that is, mother of life itself, by your hand we were formed. You made us relational. You created us to thrive, not alone but together. You shape the entire cosmos so that every form of life depends on another. You never intended for us to power through these lives alone. You made us strong and resistant people, but equally vulnerable and dependent on you, the earth, and all our neighbors. You gifted us with the need to rely on one another, bone of each other's bone, flesh of each other's flesh. In your wisdom, you created us with both desire and need to be in community. Therefore, we join our voices with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, singing praise to you, Holy, Holy One, God of justice and love, heaven and earth are full of your wonder. Hosanna among us. In our longing for your presence with us, we often expect your arrival in traditional places of power. We seek our hope and salvation in the false promises of dominance and might. But instead, you brought us salvation through vulnerability. You too became bone of our bone, flesh of our flesh. God, in the form of a baby, you made yourself dependent on us, an infant revealing the transformative power of giving and receiving love through human flesh. Throughout the life of Jesus, we saw lives transformed by your willingness to make yourself vulnerable, and yet the same vulnerability also came at a price. Though some fed you and raised you and befriended you, others persecuted you to the point of death. Seeking to eradicate their own feelings of vulnerability, those in power preyed on yours. Still today, we often crucify the ones who dare to risk it all on love. On the night of his arrest, Jesus shared a meal with his companions. He took bread, blessed it, broke it, gave it to the disciples, and said, "This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After the meal, he took the cup, blessed it, shared it, saying, "This cup that is poured out is a new covenant. In remembrance of all you have done to save us, we proclaim the mystery of our faith. Christ was birthed among us. Christ was killed among us. Christ rises again among us. Pour out your spirit on these gifts, O God. Give us a taste of resurrection hope that lasts through even the most challenging and relational betrayals. Meet us in this bread and this cup, and hear the prayers of our people in the aching world. Come, O come, Emmanuel. In collective longing for a taste of your kingdom on earth, we join together in echoing the prayer of Jesus, our Creator, who art in heaven. Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. As you prepare to come forward for communion, remember to say thanks be to God as you are offered communion. As a reminder that our table is open to all, So, if you're not able to come forward in body, just raise your hand afterwards and we'll bring you communion. Also, the ushers have made it a little more easy for you. So, as you take your cup and you drink the juice, you have an empty tray that you can put your cup, therefore making it easier for our ushers not to have to go around afterwards picking up all the invisible cups that are on the juice. God, we recognize the ways you still make yourself vulnerable to us today. In gratitude for a taste of your kingdom, may our discipleship shape us into fierce protectors of the vulnerable, give us courage to practice of our own vulnerability, and help us to honor the sacredness of our need for one another. In Christ's name we pray, amen. At this time of our service, we share our intentions, our joys, our concerns with each other, so that not only God knows what they are, but your church family can also pray with you. Anybody else? Either everybody's good or everybody's shy. We continue to pray for our church community and our community at large, for Barbara, for Dorothy, for Bill, and for Ray, who still is living with the side effects of an aneurysm. For all those who are in need of food, a home, a job, we lift them up to God so that God knows what they need and can serve them what it is that they need at this time. We also celebrate those who have birthdays and anniversaries this week. May they be blessed. May they have a joyful day. Laboring God with axe and winning fork, you clear a holy space where hurt and destruction have no place. And a little child holds sway, clear our lives of hatred and despair. Sow seeds of joy and peace as shoots of hope and brings forth, and we may live in harmony with one another. Let us pray in the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. At this time, I invite you all to continue to give, not just of yourselves, but physically, so that our ministries can continue in this congregation and for the community at large. Marvelous are the gifts of God's grace. Let us respond with wonder and delight by offering our very selves back to God. With reverence and devotion, let us give generously of our gifts, that through our offerings, God's promises might be fulfilled.
Thank you.
Gracious God, you offer us a gift beyond price. Your Son is like the sweet kiss of rain on a barren land. Your promised salvation is like the bread of heaven for those who are perishing. In gratitude for your abundant gifts, we commit ourselves to act justice in solidarity with the poor, and we pledge our assistance to those who are in need. May the gifts we bring before you this day hasten the day when none shall hurt or destroy on all your holy mountain. Amen. As you stand in body or spirit, I remind you that our Christmas set is having food for us afterwards in Wabi Hall, so please join them as they celebrate also a successful Christmas pageant. Please stand in body or spirit. Live in harmony with one another through the hope we find in Christ Jesus. Act with righteousness and peace, that justice may flourish and peace may be abound. Love with hope and grace, that joy may fill your days like sunshine on a cold winter's day. Amen.
I invite you again to join me in our benediction response that's printed in your bulletin. It says, Lord, make me more holy, just singing that first verse through.
To mention that Holly will be ordering poinsettias again, so suggested donation is $25, and you can either drop it off in the office or just bring it in next Sunday with you, and she'll have them here soon.